Tonight's dua, inshaAllah ta'ala, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud narrated this hadith, and the hadith is in Bukhari, in Muslim. قال كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول اللهم إني أسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى. سبحان الله. Very beautiful, comprehensive dua. Imam Sa'di rahimahullah, he said this dua covers the khair of the deen and the dunya. This dua, those four things cover everything about the deen and everything about the dunya. The first two will take care of the deen, and the second two will take care of the dunya. Allahumma inni as'aluka al-huda. Ya Allah, I ask you guidance. And Rasulullah ﷺ left it open. He did not just say guidance in the deen. Number one is the guidance in the deen, because it's great ni'mah to be a Muslim, but another great ni'mah is to be a guided Muslim. So I'm asking Allah to guide me in the matters of the deen. Guide me to the best of salat. Guide me to the best of dua. Guide me to the best of ibadat in general. And also guide me in all my affairs, all my dunya affairs. Guide me to take the right decisions. Allahumma inni as'aluka al-huda. Huda is guidance, open guidance, all kinds of guidance to any khair. Allahumma inni as'aluka al-huda wa tuqa. Tuqa is from Muttaqeen, right? Al-Muttaqeen are the people who have taqwa. We all want to be from the Muttaqeen. I beg Allah Azza wa Jal in this blessed night of Friday to make us all from the Muttaqeen. At-Tuqa is to build a barrier between you and anything that is haram. Allah said, وَاتَّقُوا النَّارَ الَّتِي أُعِدَّتْ لِلْكَافِرِينَ. And have taqwa from the nar. What does that mean? Build a barrier between you and the hellfire. That means build a barrier from anything that might lead to the hellfire. طيب, when Allah said, وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهِ, what does that mean? Build a barrier between you and anything that's not pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. At-taqwa is to do everything that Allah ordered and to stay away from what he has prohibited. So I'm asking Allah Azza wa Jal here, Allahumma inni as'aluka al-huda wa-tuqa wal-afafa. Subhanallah. Al-afaf, probably the closest translation is chastity. Afaf is when someone is afif, he is yani clean and pure from mainly the fahisha of zina. Okay, but not only the zina, the major zina, but ya Allah, I'm asking you protection from the zina of the ayn. Because Rasulullah ﷺ, he told us, وَإِنَّ الْعَيْنَ لَتَزْنِي. The ayn commits zina also. So I'm asking Allah from the afaf in all the parts of my body. Afaf from every aspect. And the last one, subhanAllah, وَالْغِنَى. Ghina, in translation probably, you're going to find it, ghina means richness, okay? And there's nothing wrong to ask for ghina in mal, in wealth. But here ghina, Rasulullah ﷺ said, and the hadith is in Bukhari, he said, إِنَّ لَيْسَ الْغِنَى عَنْ كَثْرَةِ الْعَرَضِ وَلَكِنَّ الْغِنَى غِنَى النَّفْسِ. Rasulullah ﷺ said, richness is not the richness of wealth, but richness is to have richness in your soul. So here ghina means freedom from needing others. Wallahi. You know, one of the dua that I personally make all the time, ya Allah, take my soul before I need anybody to shower me, to help me, to feed me, to spend on me. So subhanAllah, I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make me self-sufficient. I don't want to need anybody. I don't want to need no one. SubhanAllah. Ghina from anyone, from needing anything, from anybody. SubhanAllah. So, ya akhwan, very beautiful four things that amazing, taught to us by Rasulullah SAW, and the hadith is 100% authentic. Okay, as usual, we repeat it after each other. Allahumma inni as'aluka al-huda wa-tuqa wal-afafa wal-ghina. When can I say this? You could say this in your sujood, you could say this before the taslim, you can say this at any time, especially when the dua is accepted. And subhanAllah, this is a blessed night. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the night of Friday to give us all these dua that we have learned, inshaAllah ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us all. May Allah make our last deeds our best deeds, and make our last words, La ilaha illallah. And make sure you make a lot of salat on Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because it's the night of Friday, and we'll see you tomorrow at Fajr, inshaAllah, at 6:15. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.